Thank you all for joining today. My name is Michael Sarur, and I am the Vice President of Sales and Marketing at Verdant Technologies. And what we're going to talk about today is energy. Energy, how to save energy for your hotels, and specifically, how to achieve a significant levels of energy saving without compromising the comfort of your guests. Because that's the key in the hospitality industry, as we all know. Hotels are in business to cater to their guests. And if any measure that you implement in your hotel is one that is compromising the comfort of your guests, well, then you really didn't achieve anything productive at all. So energy is certainly a hot topic these days. It's something that is on the forefront of everyone's kind of minds, and energy costs are going up all the time in North America. As a matter of fact, on average, energy costs are going up by about 5%. Specifically, in North America and in California, energy costs are amongst the highest in North America. North American average is just under 10 cents a kilowatt hour. Out here on the West Coast, we see kilowatt hours that are being sold for 15, 16, 20 cents pretty regularly. So certainly an appropriate setting for our conversation today. Now, the hospitality industry is unique. It's unique in many ways. Specifically, as it relates to energy, the hospitality industry is very much incentivized to reduce their energy consumption. And when I say incentivized, the main players there are the utility companies, as well as state and federal governments. Utility companies in particular are very, very much aggressive in the way that they incentivize commercial businesses, lodging especially, to reduce their energy consumption. It might seem counterintuitive that a utility company wants to encourage their customers to consume less of the product that they're actually selling, but if you understand the background and the way that the federal government passes off tax credits to utility companies that end up spending a lot of these kind of incentive dollars, it makes a lot of sense. And if any of you are hotel managers or operators and have experience dealing with your utility company, you'll see that the utility companies are actually very much cooperative and very eager to give away those dollars. Generally, utility incentives for energy efficiency measures are categorized in two ways. They can either be prescriptive incentives. A prescriptive incentive is one where the utility has already kind of categorized or defined the measure that you're implementing, and as a result has associated a dollar amount to it. An example, at our company Verdant, we sell energy management thermostat systems. Duke Energy, just one on the top of my head, has categorized our product as hotel guest room HVAC controls and has associated an incentive of $80 per thermostat or per room to each one of our thermostats. So these are the easy incentives to get because they're a fixed dollar amount to them. You buy a product, send an invoice to your utility, the utility sends you a check for $80 times X amount of product. The other category, which is a little bit more tricky, are custom incentives. Custom incentives are one where the utility has not yet defined the measure, and as a result, they will pay you an incentive which is based on the amount of energy that they will project that you'll save over a given period of time. So some projections are involved, some energy saving calculations are involved. So the process can be a little bit more involved, a little bit more tedious, but typically in the end, the amount of incentive is the same. So the idea, just to kind of summarize, is that utility companies who are incentivized by their governments to give out money are doing so specifically. Now, let's talk specifically about hotels and where we can save some energy and how we can save some energy and, by consequence, save money. Because that's what we're talking about here. So, a hotel is also unique in the way that they consume energy. Hotels are comprised largely of rooms, obviously, and the biggest consumer of energy within a hotel room is without a doubt heating and air conditioning. Especially these days with new technology, LED lights for example, things like lighting and television and all kinds of other appliances in the room really represent a minority, a very small amount of the electricity being consumed in hotel rooms. The big consumer in a hotel room is your heating and or your air conditioning, or a combination of both, depending on geographically where you are. So being able to reduce your guest room heating and air conditioning consumption is a very direct path to energy savings. Now, again, hospitality is unique. So how are you able to reduce heating and air conditioning in a guest room? Well, if I was the owner of an office building, for example, it'd be very easy for me to save energy as far as heating and air conditioning goes. I'd walk over to my local Home Depot and I'd buy a $40 programmable thermostat, and I'd stick it in every area of the office building, and I'd program it so that the heating or air conditioning comes on at 7:30 a.m. before my workers arrive, or my tenants, I should say, arrive, and then I would do the opposite around 6 or 7 p.m. when I know the building is going to be pretty much empty. Unfortunately, in hotel rooms, that system doesn't work, because we all know that occupancy in a hotel room is random. We have no idea when people are going in and out of a room. The same can be said with a university dorm room, maybe a healthcare facility, or really any type of building that has compartmentalized individual temperature control and where occupancy patterns are very much random. In a setting like that, a programmable thermostat simply does not work. You need to have some sort of temperature control which is based on occupancy to identify when guests are going in and out of a room. So the first thing you're looking for in a good occupancy detection system is a reliable method of determining, is a room occupied or not occupied? For example, at Verdant Technologies, we employ a combination of both motion and body heat to determine whether or not there's a person in the room. That is a very reliable and effective way to determine if, in fact, an individual is in the room. Now, as hotel operators, when your guests are in the room, you want them to have full control over the temperature in their room. I know I'm a little crazy. I like the temperature in my room to be nice and cold, 67, 68 degrees. I know that my associate is, polar opposite. He likes it at 74, 75, and all that is great, except when we leave the room. When I'm standing here at High Tech all day, I can tell you that my hotel room, and my hotel will remain nameless, but my hotel room is still pumping 67 degrees of air conditioning while I'm gone. That's a tremendous amount of waste. I'll be gone about 8 hours today. I estimate, based on my expertise in the industry, that they'll probably throw about 60 cents in the garbage today because I'm not in the room and they're pumping air conditioning out. If they had an occupancy sensor in that room that knew that in fact the room was empty and was able to set back temperature in the room to a reasonable temperature, now I'd be very upset if I walked into a room that was 90 degrees, but if I walked into a room that was only a few degrees warmer than where I left it, which was still a reasonable temperature, but enough that it would save a significant amount of energy, the hotel would be much better off at the end of the year in terms of their electricity expenses go. So occupancy detection is the key to be able to have an effective energy management system as far as guest room heating and air conditioning goes in the hotel. Now, if we implement a system like this, how much energy can we save? There are several hundred hotels out there using our product, several hundred more using competitive products. And on average, a hotel that is able to set back temperature to a reasonable level when the hotel room is unoccupied is usually able to reduce their heating and air conditioning runtime within the room by about 40%. These are claims that are pretty typical in the industry, anywhere from 30 to 50% runtime reduction in the room. On average, depending on the type of hotel, whether it's a limited service hotel or a full service hotel, that will typically translate to a reduction in your annual electric cost of somewhere between 15 and 20%. So by implementing an occupancy detection based system to automatically adjust your temperature control in the room, you'll end up realizing about a 15% drop in your electric bill at the end of the year. All that is very, very nice. But the key to an effective energy management system is one that will achieve this level of savings without compromising the comfort of your guest. And that's really the theme of today's session here. It's not only to learn a little bit more about effective ways to save energy in a hotel, but ways to save energy in a hotel that go largely unnoticed as far as hotel guests are concerned. We like to believe in our company, Verdant, that's where we specialize. And we do that through a series of different features and approaches where we feel are very, very important to be able to achieve this level of energy savings, again, unnoticed as far as the guests are concerned. So today what we're gonna do in the next few slides is we're gonna talk about the way that we do it, and our competitors may do it, you know, in different ways. So let's look at the first one. Without a doubt, the biggest challenge in achieving a high level of energy savings without compromising guest comfort is nighttime. An occupancy-based system depends largely on somebody moving around in the room, even if it's, you know, body heat. Nighttime can be challenging. And as much as our occupancy detection is really top of the line and state of the art, there still is this risk at night for even the best sensor to believe that a guest sleeping in a bed, perhaps under heavy blankets, is in fact an empty room, and to erroneously set back temperatures. There are a number of ways that companies like ours try and combat this problem using all kinds of other devices in the room, like sensors on doors and things like that. We do it in a different way. We do it through a patented piece of software that we have built into our thermostat, which is called Night Occupancy Mode. It ain't rocket science, but it's very clever and very effective. Night Occupancy Mode is a piece of software built into each thermostat that tells the unit, if I detect any activity, any action in this room in the evening, at night, I must assume this is a guest that has rented this room and will sleep there. I think we can all agree that if anyone's hanging out in a hotel room at 8 or 9 at night, it ain't the staff, and they've probably rented the room, they're going to sleep there. Our thermostat makes those assumptions and says, let me go ahead and suspend setback until the morning. So that is one very effective, simple, straightforward approach to solving this problem of night. And again, achieving the overall goal of a high level of energy savings without compromising guest comfort. We offer a guarantee that our thermostats will never generate guest complaints at night because of this erroneous setback. So that's one area where you can achieve the goal. Another example, and again, this is the way we do it. Some other companies do it in a different way. But we offer something built into each thermostat called dynamic intelligent recovery. So this general idea of telling the thermostat, all right, when the room is empty, you can now set back. You can allow the temperature in the room to go as low as, I don't know, 65 degrees and as high as 80 degrees. It's very nice in theory, except I think we can all agree that in some areas, maybe right here in Los Angeles, in the middle of August, if we let a room get all the way up to 80 degrees, when a guest walks back in, it might take a little bit of time to cool down, especially if you're like me and you like the room at, you know, 67 degrees. It might take a while for the room to get from 80 degrees to 66 degrees when I enter the room, and that might be an area where you might generate some guest complaints. So again, a way that we combat this problem is through this dynamic intelligent recovery, which is again software built into each thermostat, where we can tell our thermostat the maximum amount of time that we will allow for the room to recover to a reasonable temperature. So in addition to having a ceiling and a floor, so to speak, in terms of setback temperatures, we also have a maximum allowable recovery time. So we tell our thermostats, when somebody walks back into that hotel room, you need to be able to recover back to a nice temperature within 15 minutes, for example, which is a reasonable amount of time. Now, in one room, the thermostat might say, you know what, in this room, I feel I can go to 80 and come back to, you know, wherever, 72 degrees within 15 minutes. So I will. I'll go to 80. But in another room, the thermostat says, for whatever reason, I'm having a hard time cooling down this room. I will not be able to go to 80 and come back down within 15 minutes. So I'll only go to 74, 75, 76, whatever. Again, the general idea is how can we squeeze out a high level of energy savings really as much as we can without compromising the comfort of the guest, and that's another way that this feature tries to achieve that goal. And just to be clear, the way that our thermostats are able to kind of determine this is by measuring what we call slew rate. It's the amount of time or the rate at which a room will cool down or heat up when we've shut down the air conditioning. By measuring that rate, we can determine, hey, this room cools up or heats down a lot more easily than this one or that one. And we're sampling those rates at different times of the day. So our thermostats constantly have a good idea of where they are, what their environment is, and how they need to react to different situations. So we've identified a couple of problems and a couple of ways that we can solve them. Let's talk about one more.
when we're talking about an effective energy management system, or really any type of technology that's going to be effective in a hotel, we must consider ease of implementation, and ease of operation. There are a lot of really great systems out there, but if they're going to cost you a fortune to implement, and they are going to be a headache to maintain and operate and run, then what we see a lot in our industry is they end up being disabled. I can't tell you how many customers we've spoken to that have bought in this system or that system and said, you know, it was great, but after a while, we just couldn't keep up, and we've disabled it, and we've spent all this money, and we're not actually achieving the level of savings we wanted to because the system is just too complex. So one of the things that an educated, you know, buyer or hotel manager or hotel operator should be looking for an effective energy management system is ease of implementation and ease of operation. And this kind of strays away from energy management. This really goes to any type of system that you want to implement in your hotel. Specifically energy management, because unless you're using it, you aren't achieving the savings. So one of the ways that we're able to achieve this kind of really simple and straightforward system is by building in wireless mesh networking into each and every one of our thermostats. What that means is that when you're implementing a Verdant system, for example, you're simply putting thermostats on the guest room walls the same way as you would with any thermostat in the world, and you're plugging a little box with an antenna into the front desk, and that's it. Built into the thermostats are the signal repeaters and boosters and technology and wireless systems that are needed to make sure that all the thermostats are talking to one another and reporting back to the internet and doing what they need to do. So again, ease of installation and ease of implementation is key to ensuring that a system works right. If your hotel needs to be rigged up and every time there's a problem, you need to identify a connection and a wire and glitch and a repeater and things like that, it's a nightmare. You won't use the system, and it goes without saying that you won't save energy. So the third area where we can identify a characteristic you should be looking for in a system that is easy to operate is definitely ease of implementation. I think we're gonna pause here, actually. Let's go back. We're gonna pause here, and we are going to see at this point if there are any questions. We've talked about a lot. I've really, you know, given you a mouthful. So let's see if there are any questions here or any questions that I can address. Yes, sir.
Two questions.
Yes, sir.
The first one, do you have any means of integrating with, like, door sensors for properties where you might have a door to a balcony?
Sure.
And if it's left open, obviously you don't want the system running the whole time combating that.
Absolutely. Absolutely. So specifically our system offers as an accessory what we call a window or patio door sensor, which allows you to, you know, hook up to a patio door just as you're describing, which will disable the air conditioning or reduce the air conditioning, really customizable in the way that you want it to treat the situation once a patio door or a window is opened, so that you're not, you know, cooling downtown Los Angeles, right? That would be a tremendous waste of energy. We offer a wireless version, again, part of our kind of simple ease of implementation. It's basically a magnet that you put onto the door, another one that you put onto the door frame, and it will be paired up to the thermostat and tell it, hey, this door is open, what do you want me to do? And part of our customizable features is, you know, for example, disable the air conditioning or set it back or, you know, do whatever. So the answer is yes, absolutely. Now, I will talk about something else which is related to that. We offer a network of these patio or window door switches. What we don't do, very deliberately, is put switches or interfaces at the entry point, at the front door. And the reason for that is because we don't need to. We are very proud to be the only energy management control system that meets major brand standards such as Hilton Worldwide and, you know, Marriott and Best Western and really all the rest of them without the requirement for this lock interface or a front door interface. And the reason for that is, number one, our sensors are scanning the room constantly. They don't just wait for some sort of entry point to open or close. And number two, these sophisticated pieces of software, such as our night occupancy mode and our intelligent recovery, totally eliminate the need for that. So again, it all comes down to this idea of a system that is simple to implement. One thermostat kit per room. If you want to add some sensors to the windows or patios, you can, but that pretty much is it. Good question. Did you have a second question?
Yeah. Can you integrate with PMS so that when a room's not booked,
sure,
you can go to more extreme default settings?
Right. So the quick answer to the question is yes. If I had to answer with one word, I'd say yes. I think you know me well enough by now that I won't stop at one word. I'll give you a little bit more of an elaborate answer. In many cases,
or in the large majority of the cases, our customers realize that it's really not necessary with our system. A system that is analyzing occupancy patterns properly and a system that is setting back intelligently, for the most part, does not actually require an integration from a PMS or any type of input from a third party, whether it be a system to tell you that you're checked in or checked out, or whether it's somebody on the hotel staff. So what we've found is, even though it's something that is possible, the large majority of our customers end up trying our system at first without PMS integration, realizing that it works highly effectively that way, and opt to avoid the additional work and expenses or reoccurring expenses that their PMS company might end up charging them for this integration, and using our system as a totally independent system. So the answer to the question is, can we? Yes. For the large majority of our customers, it's something that is done. Good questions. Any other questions? Yes, sir.
Do you have a less expensive non-Wi-Fi product?
Yes. So first of all, I should clarify that the wireless network that we're talking about has nothing to do with Wi-Fi. So big advantage that our system has is that our wireless communication will not depend on, nor will it interfere with, a hotel's existing Wi-Fi or Zigbee or any other type of wireless networks that we have. We've developed our own proprietary wireless communication protocol. It's done at a radio frequency of about 918 megahertz. So all of our thermostats talk to each other and then talk back to the central gateway, so to speak, on a very effective 918 radio frequency, which is very, very reliable and independent. So that's the first thing that I should clarify, nothing to do with Wi-Fi. And then to answer your question directly, yes. A lot of our customers purchase standalone thermostats from us, which means no ability to remotely manage the network of thermostats. These are just standalone thermostats that control the HVAC unit either with wires or without. All of the settings that we talked about, like setback, max allowable recovery time, beginning and end of night occupancy mode, are all set directly onto the thermostat at installation. In order to facilitate that, we've grouped different levels of settings into five energy presets, which is what we call them. So you can take a look at the manual and say, I like recipe number 3, so I'm gonna install this thermostat, set it to room 120, choose level 3, move on to the next one. Or you can individually set up all these settings one by one. So that would be our standalone system, or you can upgrade to a system that can be remotely managed, controlled, adjusted via the internet. And our remote management tool is all web-based, which means that you're not limited to one particular terminal at the hotel or one particular computer at the front desk. It's web-based. I'm constantly on my smartphone, logging into hotels, assisting my customers from anywhere in the world, adjusting thermostat settings, generating reports, things like that. So standalone thermostats, as well as ones that can be upgraded to be remotely managed. Yes, sir. I'm sorry, sir, could you speak up a little bit?
Sorry, you're saying that you don't have an interface or the door lock system.
I'm sorry, I'm going to come up to you because I can't. Yes, sir.
You're saying that you don't need interface with door lock.
Yes, correct. Excellent question. What was your name, sir?
Sandesh.
Sandesh asked a great question. Don't he need to interface with a door switch at the front door or a lock interface. Then how do you identify if someone on the hotel staff, like a housekeeper, is entering the room, and how do you treat that situation? Again, software, simple approach, built into every thermostat is a feature called incidental occupancy, where our thermostats are able to identify occurrences of what we call incidental occupancy based on the length of the occupancy and the time of day where they're occurring, and treat those in really any way that you'd like to. So much in the same way that we'll say, all right, a door's open, what do you want to do now? We also say, hey, a housekeeper's in the room, what do you want to do now? So it's all done via this software-based approach where, by analyzing occupancy patterns, we're able to identify those situations without the need for additional equipment, which we all know means additional cost, additional headaches, additional opportunities for problems. Does that answer your question? Great. Any other questions? I can say gentlemen, because I don't see a woman in the room. Yes.
Given the standard energy rates that you quoted earlier, I mean,
yes.
Have you guys done, you guys done studies as far as what the typical ROI time is on an investment?
Absolutely. Again, I'll give you the quick answer and then the long answer. Quick answer is about a year. That's the quick answer. On average, hotels that implement our system will achieve enough savings in 1 year that it will completely offset the cost of our system. Obviously, that's not the case for every hotel. We've seen situations where it is as quick as 5 months, and we've seen situations where it's as long as 2 years. So the factors that would be considered there, number one is geography, and that really has two parts to it. So geography will determine what type of utility incentive you'll get, also what type of climate you have, which will dictate how much savings you'll get, and that will play a role as well. And the other big part of the equation is the utility incentive. So if you're in an area where your utility is covering 50% of your bill, obviously your ROI or your payback will be much quicker than in an area, as limited as they are, that don't have any incentives, but you know they do exist. So on average though, about 12 months, I would say 10 to 15 months is kind of the meaty part of the bell curve. Yep, yes sir. I'm sorry, say that again?
Do you integrate with any control systems like Control 4 or restaurant or Riptide lighting?
Right. Good question. Currently, we do not. Currently, we are a system that is completely autonomous. We are really proud of our web-based remote management interface. It's a very, very, very powerful tool. And we feel that HVAC is really a beast unto itself, which is really very much being controlled and accessed by maintenance. And that's really a tool that is specific to them. So right now we are not. It is something that we may become open to in the future, but right now we have a totally independent, powerful, and autonomous web-based remote management tool. Yes?
Just wanted to add another question. So the 12-month average ROI, is that assuming
It's assuming a very conservative average rebate. So I would say that the median rebate that we see is about $75, $80 a room. At a 12-month ROI, I'm probably assuming about 40 or 50. Okay? So it's very much average. Now, on that topic, one of the things that we offer to our customers to really try and identify what the ROI will be before a customer needs to make a financial commitment is a free trial. Now, you know, as a vendor, obviously, it's a good business decision to say, here, try out a thermostat, see if you like it. But we really take it a step further. What we offer our customer base is the opportunity to try our system on a larger scale for a longer period of time so that we can actually measure savings and have an accurate, honest projection of what a real payback will be. So the way that we do it is really kind of honest and transparent. We say, look, we'll give you a couple dozen thermostats and we'll let you have them for a few months. And what we will do is we will implement them in, let's say, 20, 25 rooms, but we will split those rooms into two categories. Category number one will be what we call EMS off. EMS off means that the sensor in the thermostat of those rooms will be disabled. Basically, what we're mimicking is a scenario with no energy management. We're basically turning our thermostat into a quote-unquote dumb thermostat that keeps pumping out 67 degrees of air conditioning even when I'm at the convention on day. In the other dozen rooms, we will enable the sensor and we will do all the wonderful things that we talked about today as far as setback and night occupancy and all that. At the end of a month or two, we will actually track the air conditioning and heating run times in all of the rooms, and we will compare the EMS off versus EMS on rooms so that we can say, all right, well, on average, the 12 rooms where energy management was enabled, the air conditioning was running 4 hours a day. But in the rooms where air conditioning or energy management, I should say, was disabled, we were running 8 hours of air conditioning. That's an average daily runtime reduction of 4 hours based on the equipment in that room, which we will, you know, input into our system. That will mean a savings of 6 kilowatt hours a day. And based on your actual utility rate, that represents a savings of, you know, 70 cents per room per day. At 70 cents per room per day, that's a savings of, you know, over $200 a year. If our thermostats cost $200, that's an ROI of a year. So, you know, we don't want you to base yourself on averages because your hotel may not be average. So we want you to be able to try the system, measure savings at your hotel with your equipment, your guests, your geography, and then we'll send you a proposal with a projected payback based on our testing. And at that point, if you're happy with the system, fantastic. We can move forward and welcome you to the family of Verdant Energy Saving Hotels, or we can take back our equipment and part as friends, and that's that. So I think that you know, it's a testament to our confidence in our system that we offer free trials to any and every hotel that wants them, and we make absolutely no, you know, we put absolutely no commitment or no obligation on a hotel to buy our system. If you like it, great. If you don't, that's fine too. We'll lend you the equipment. We'll even pay for the shipping because we're confident in it. Any other questions, gentlemen? I think our timing was impeccable because it's 12:30 on the nose, which means that there's probably a presenter waiting outside. I thank you very much for your time today. I will encourage you all to join us at booth 1249, where we are doing live demos of our remote management. We can actually take a tour of some real hotels using our system and get a look.